The topic is describing a distribution. So let's read the problem. There's a histogram here. This display shows the height of some of the singers in a chorus collected so that the singers could be positioned on stage with shorter ones in front and taller ones in back. And we need to describe the distribution. First thing you always need to look at is what is the variable. Variable again is always going to be in the x-axis, and in this case it's the height of singers. So that's our distribution. The distribution is the height of singers, and of course here it's given just the number of singers. In other words, there are four singers with the heights between 60 and 62 inches. All right, so let's describe this distribution. The definition says, first thing you need to look at is whether it's unimodal, bimodal, multimodal, or uniform. Unimodal is the one that has one mode or one hump. Bimodal is the one that have two modes or two humps. And this is the case, multimodal that has more, uniform that has no mode. So we can tell these two modes, one mode between 64 and 66 inches, and another one between 70 and 72 inches. They don't have to be equal, but you can tell they're two modes. In other words, there are two groups of people that are, or two clusters. All right, so far we know it's a bimodal, so let's write that one. The height of singers distribution, or the distribution. It's always nice to start with the distribution. The distribution of the heights of singers in this course, or in course, in the course, is bimodal. Now, every time we talk about bimodal, we need to talk about both groups or both clusters. Are they symmetric? Are they skewed? Well, we can tell both of them, they are a bit symmetric, right? Both clusters are a bit symmetric. Now we need to talk about center. Since they are symmetric, it's better to talk about mean, even though the mean is almost equal to the median. So the mean will be right there. It's kind of like 64, 65 inches. So the mean 65 for the first group, and it's kind of like 70, 71 inches for the second group. So cluster one has mean equal to, said 65 inches, and cluster two has mean equal, we said, about 71 inches. So if we want to talk about range, can talk about the IQR, but because it's a symmetric, but we can just say the range for each cluster, just like the regular range. So regular range goes from, for the first group, I say it goes from 60 to what, 67? So the range of the first cluster is between 60 inches, 60 and 68 actually. And the range of the second cluster goes from 69 to 76, something like that. Doesn't have to be perfect. It's between 69 inches and 76 inches. All right, now next question is, can you account for the features you see here? Why do we have to? If you look at the group of people, there's a group that average 96 inches and another group of people that averages 76 inches. What can you think of? There's only one way. There's only one answer for this. Those are females and males. So, of course, females, we all know they're shorter than males. So, cluster 1 represents males, while, I mean females, oops, that's the one with the shorter mode. So, females, while cluster 2 represents males. And that's it for this example.